We're the Ghostbusters. We're clever, courageous, and strong. Hello, everybody. We are back with Build the Ghostbusters Acto 1, Issue 15. Issue 15 consists of four stages, which I will quickly run through you. Stage 51 will be the details on the driver's rear side workstation where we worked on last time. This is going to be an enormous amount of modification. Stage 52, which is quite simple, which is just the cargo area work floor and some screws. We are not working on this today. We're working on stage 51. But believe me, it's a lot of things we have to do on stage 51, even though it may look like it's not much. Here we have the parts for stage 51. Let's take a closer look at these parts. Now, I already took out the screws. Those are safely aside. We got some rubber hoses, which are going to be installed later, but in a different way than the instruction manual says. And we're going to be using, again, the assistance of that website, which I always show you. Well, show you over here, because he has done some research on how these cables are actually going to be going in, and why reinvent the wheel if he already done the research. Let's follow his lead. The first thing we need to do according to the instructions is screw in these parts over here, this silver piece. Hold on, let me see if I can get it out. This silver piece onto this piece. We're going to do some painting. With this part now screwed in, I need to paint the tips of the screws because they are black. And of course they need to, originally there are no screws in this part, but so I need to paint those the same color, silver. The same goes for this part over here, which I have already pre-painted. Made a aluminum plateau. These are painted chrome silver as much as possible. These parts are black. And this centerpiece over here is green. Now, this block over here, if you can see it, this block over here, normally it shouldn't be here, but I'm not going to use a Dremel to take it out because I fear I might damage the entire part more than necessary. And these little things over here are actually switches. The part is to be screwed on over here. And then the next thing we need to do is take these rubber-like hoses we have over here and stick them into the holes over here, and then have them maneuver all around this part. But, and this is a big but, once again I'm following the website which I've placed over here. This guy has made some research, and he suggests that the rubber hoses do not start over here. They actually start in holes over here. So we need to make some holes in here with the drill and then put in these rubber hoses. That's the first thing I'm going to do. First I'm going to drill some holes, then I'm going to screw them into place. Okay, it's a bit difficult, so let me quickly go back to the instructions, the part list. We got three sets of rubber tube. So we got the F, the E, and the D. The D are the shortest, the E are the middle size, and the F are the longest. And the F actually is folded, so it will fit in the box. So what we need to do, one of these longer ones, we just lay it on here over here, behind this part, all the way over there, and then use another tape to make it stick over there. This is going to be added later in the build. The shortest of the two pipes are going into these holes over here. The middle size of these pipes are going over these holes. Now we got two holes left in the center. What we need to do is take the longest one, cut that thing in half. So let's find the exact center of this pipe, and there it goes, in half. and we need to stick that or those two in these holes. So that's the that's that part done. Let's do that right now, and we need a little bit of glue to stick them in because the holes are a bit too big. I just made it a bit too big. So here's some reasonable glue, and then stick them in. Okay, with all the six tubes in, and this one is separate, of course, from the six, we're gonna bind them together, just like in the original instructions suggests. Let me pull this one a bit further, and they are going to go over here. But before we're gonna put them all together, we're gonna use some what we call these tie rips, cable ties. But these included ones in the kit are far too large. Now luckily I purchased a number of these some year ago for the DeLorean. These are smaller. Let me give you an example of what they look like in size comparison. These are the originals from Eagle Moss. These are the ones I got. Now you can get smaller than these from Mike Lane, but these will do, these small ones will do. So what we need to do is to make sure that all these seven cables are now linked together using one of these cable ties. So I'm not going to put them very tight, but just make sure that they stay together. Okay, that's it. Not tighter than that, because I want to make sure that all the cables are taut. Okay. Now we can actually pull this cable in. Okay. So that's how it's gonna look. And it says these cables are going to go underneath over here. Okay, so this will go this way then. And go like so. I'm gonna put more of these cable ties in. So as soon as that is done, I'll return with the video. Okay, it's done. I put a total of three of those cable ties. One over here, one over there, and one over there. Now these cables, of course, as I said, have to move around this part. But for now, I'm using a tape to make sure that they stay in position. They later will be placed somewhere else, but for now that is done. So talking about that is actually stage 51 done. So next time we actually will be going into the construction of the large cargo floor, but we're going to do some small modifications on that as well. Apart from that, we're also going to screw in this part into the cargo, but that is for later. So that is for, as I said, later. Anyway, thank you so much for joining me in this this build. I hope you will subscribed to this channel, and if not, please do so. It doesn't cost you anything, and it will the more subscribers I get for this channel, the more beneficial it will be for my channel as a whole. If you can't subscribe, or you do not want to subscribe, there's no harm done. You can leave me a message behind on this message, on this video as well. That also will help the algorithm of YouTube. And that's the way it is, unfortunately. But thank you so much for joining me. You been watching this video will also help a little bit. So everything you do helps, hey, for you. Anywho, see you all next time, and bye-bye. Trouble soon fade, the Ghostbusters do it
again. B&T, custom-made models and dioramas. Ha-ha, like you click, and subscribe you must.